interestingly enough, we did hear that, yes, that's true, LW Red has not lost to NC Foxes, but last time we saw these two teams play back in Challenger, it was a 3-2. It was a close series. So he may have, you know, thrown it out there, Roll was being pretty confident.
What we see the Junkrat is because a lot of choke points on this map where Genji's dashes will get extra damage and where Wicked will be able to do more damage to his mines, but so far pretty unsuccessful.
I say it. Okay, Wicked's just going to, like, EMP, who really cares? Akino's going to be able to pick up double pulse bomb kill, though. This could be the start of something for NC Foxes, cleaning up what was an incredible shutdown by Wicked. Things are even, we're in overtime, and we're almost at that flip over. Good EMP comes in, but Wicked says no, he's going to be able to pick one up. The remote mine has an extra one, and is able to actually grab a kill with it as well. But still a fight on this point.
It's doing a lot of damage for free here, though, and I think that Foxes are losing control very quickly. They don't have that EMP anymore.
LW Red, it's been so close here on Control Center. As Ark getting himself down there and to heal up his whole team here as well, but Kino picking up that first pick may actually be big as LW Red trying to answer back with this TAC Pfizer. 1J Lee getting some decent work done, but has to move out of the way.
Dragon
can't
Blade.
Actually use the end of it. Dragon Blade was built
kill
up
here
for
onto Pumple as well, as we're trading a few.
Resist for both players. Okay, gonna be just the one. I think wanted more than that.
But NC Fox is still able to grab a lot, but that's the
four-man
res coming out from 1J Lee. He was waiting for that. He's almost gonna get punished, but Aquino's not able to lock that one down just yet. That answer was absolutely fantastic. Rocket Barrage does come in, but Wicked is going to be assassinated for it.
Killed in animation there.
Oh, nice shot by Sarsen there. Locks down Nene.
You know, it's incredible.
Hopper going to throw his out now and see whether he can find anyone, but everyone just going to jump in and hide. No! Sarsen is actually taken out, and Wicked's going to get rid of the rest of that pharmacy. So nicely played, and LW Red should have an advantage now as they've got so much more room to play with.
Have the res available as well. Don't know if they'll necessarily need it here. They'd love to hold on to it if they can, but that's a panic button they can press. Looks like it won't be necessary.
This is so clutch. But Wicked, what he's doing is he's zoning them all the way out of the way and is able to use that rocket barrage now with no one else there to challenge him. Good res does come in, but now it's going to be the advantage over the other side. NC Foxes, more men alive. We'll see whether they can actually make this one happen, and they are picking up the kills.
This entire round will be decided by that res right there, very likely. There's the kill onto Hapa. Deco had the valuable res. The barrage was way better time for Sashin. Here they come, though. They're still going to get one. It's only onto Hapa, though.
Yeah, it does actually tick over the overtime, though,
so
doesn't it? NC Foxes just haven't been able to get any flips back. They've had some decent fights, but it's never meant enough for them to actually get some decent percentage here this time around. Now they're going to lose the D.Va mech, but Nene once again just making it difficult, and NC Foxes just so low on health that they're not able to get anything meaningful back.
They don't have their support ultimates, which is a big problem here. That could buy them so much time. Pumple's already dead. Rhea's going to have to be the saving grace here. I don't know how long he's going to last, though, realistically, with this much damage. Already D-Magged.
Well, Pulse bomb. Yeah, going to fly through, but not able to get enough. Red, you know, in the same position, and they had the transcendence to throw through. Neko nowhere near his, and Wicked jumping over to the Genji to try and put the last few nails in this coffin.
They will do just that, take this win, and despite the heroics of Sashin throughout all three rounds,
going to be very, very important, and NC Foxes now able to pick up one more. LW Red making their way back. They've got double support ultimates as we're ticking down. It's going to be the overtime, though, and this still could be that full hold that you were talking about, because Raw, he's got the nano boost, he's got the primal rage, and NC Foxes are getting just beaten around. 1J Lee did fall down, and the Dragon Blade was built for. Man, he got like 60% as we were ranting for like the last couple of seconds. That's massive if the NC Foxes, he picks up Raw off the back end with the dash.
All right, looks like they will finally get this through.
It's in overtime. They just need to get a good fight on their hands.
Really,
you can see they're picking up the kills. Yeah, Wicked's going to make his way back. He's got a Dragon Blade of his own on his Genji. And even just backhands Rhea at the same time. It looks like this will be the hold just before point B. So they're picking up kills. Won't any joy whatsoever. And that's cheating, Hopper. How dare you? That was a tracer battle.
Okay, well, Foxes trying to buy time here. Rhea will go ahead and toss out the self-destruct to buy more time. No one's on this point. I'm gonna have to set up for another push.
Yeah, taking things in, matters into his own hands. And the win
Winston's able to get the work done. Lee's going to fall down, and NC Foxes, yeah, you're right.
It's all eyes on 1J Lee. That Trendsense needs to gain value. Here we go. Pumple does get that nano.
But he's a little bit too far away, to be perfectly honest.
Trendsense protecting everybody here.
But is it going to be enough here in the long run? I'm not sure. As NC Foxes, it's their turn to go on the offensive. Self-destruct flies through. We've got a sound barrier there keeping everyone alive. And NC Foxes just wanting to hold this one on point A. And they're going through, evening things out 1-1 with a full hold on Hollywood. Nicely played by the NC Foxes.
Bro, really pick off Pumble at range. He is going to get the nano, though, which has been so successful. This is part of how they defended on Hollywood. He goes a bit deep, though.
Yeah, Pumple falling down there is a bit of a blunder. But it is going to be the mech falling down as well as the Zenyatta.
Yeah,
so Sasson doing a bunch of work.
Just casually gets these kills off screen and is working to tackle Wicked as well. Nearly up the cap.
Yeah, the last minute contest coming in here. We've got about 40 seconds to go. There's a lot of pickups. They got to watch out for this potential C9, but LW Red are going to be eviscerated and removed
from remaining at the World Cup. But yeah. Beyond like that, like real high level Overwatch, I mean, we're not seeing it very often. Sasha is going to pop out the Dragon Blade. Very unsuccessful, though, so far. It's not a full hold yet, but they need to buy more time. Nene, Triss trying to use Recall to do just that, but here comes the Winston in.
Yeah, but look at that. Nene falls down at exactly the same time as the dive comes in. And we were saying that coordination was what LW Red had, but that was in position to dive in, but didn't want to do it with a man disadvantage. 2.1J Lee is going to finish that one off as Pumple once again being a bit of a beast wolf.
He's too far away. Wicked, he's not close enough to actually use his left clicks to get damage done. He's dead before he gets that ultimate that's so important, the Riptar. He won't have it.
Yeah, Akino just jumps right on top of him, and now we've got NC Foxes sitting on the point with double support ultimates and very close to a Dragon Blade as well. Sasson should be able to cancel this one out as NC Foxes throw down first the sound barrier to try and put a stopper in this, and that's going to be that. All too easy. Full hold.
Dragon Blade with Transcense if he wants to. Here it comes. There's the pairing.
Yeah, actually, Transcense immediately comes out. Yeah, exactly. So not going to be able to get too much done. We'll see what's going to wear off first, and it is going to be the Dragon Blade. So Transcendence not getting anything. Hopper gets revenge. Assassin is going to be taken down by the self-destruct. And look at this. LW Red not giving this one up without a fight, and that is the perfect place to stop this push as well. Just before point B.
That's going to be required.
OG Lee is going to use it. So he was just threatened way, way too much. Riptide's going to fly forward, but it's going to be taken out. Does eventually kill Sasson. Oh my god, I swear they were targeting that, but it just didn't quite work. And Hopper's going to be able to grab a cheeky one. Andy Hawk on the back end. It's a disaster for the NC Foxes as LW Red looking to mount this defense and capitalize correctly at the midpoint of Dorado, barely making it past halfway. And NC Foxes are going to be shut. They have all six back towards the point. 1J Lee going to make it even sweeter by taking down Akino.
Where is it going to land? Looking for maximum value, but it looks like all he could really get was most of a D.Va suit. But still, this is very successful. The Foxes already used Primal Rage, so they're not going to be able to do a last minute contest. This should almost certainly be the first checkpoint. Just don't have any tools. Hyuk is trying, but futile at this stage.
Yeah,
there's the capture. 4 minutes now to go half the way. And then they win it. They're going to try to shove this through. Sasson has the Dragon Blade. They don't have the Riptire to deny it, but he doesn't have any support ultimates to work with. They just have to toss it out blind. He cannot die here. He cannot die. All right, this is going to be the end of this map. Okay, here it comes. He's trying to get the backwards angle onto the supports. Good deflect here. Looking for 1J Lee. Gets him.
Yeah, does get it. So Dragon Blade successful for now, but Raw once again right on top of the Genji. Does just seem to be his job right now. He's playing that peel, but NC Foxes are able to at least grab some position on top of this payload. Nene takes down the mech, though, and that's going to be so, so important. Pumple's healthy, so the frontline still going to be available, and we've got Rhea actually building back up towards another suit once again. Pumple falling down means that he has to get there as quickly as possible.
Might not ever have one this game. Going really deep in here, using the Transcense to try to zone everybody out to maybe just try to backcap this. No one's on it, though. This isn't working out so far.
It's not even round the corner just yet, as Hopper's probably going to lose this mech or just be useless in this fight. Yeah, he's going to throw out the self-destruct and does pick up the kill. onto rear at the same time. So Raw throwing down the Primal Rage, and he's going to be able to clean up now as Sousin with the Dragon Blade, with a sound barrier to aid him as well. He's not actually going to throw it in. They're playing it very, very patiently. He's down extraordinarily low, and he's actually going to go, because Wicked, he had his Genji out, and he pulled out his sword. And that is going to be that.
So expose yourself to the McCree, you're going to have big problems. Oh, man, look at this Nato. Yeah. Nearly the full energy here.
Just insane. As soon as he has another shield, which he does have available, just wasn't exactly necessary right there. As there's the Deadeye. Pumple and Rhea both falling down. NC Foxes are getting some back. A nice Riptide from Akino does
take
down.
Do this with the Defense Matrix on cooldown.
Look at Neko's positioning as well. I mean, he was standing all the way out of the way. Nene and Ark are going to fall down, though, and the Rocket Barrage does come in, takes down both tanks as Wicked gets one lonely kill, but the rest of them just fall down here, and they're buying time for Wicked to come back. And speaking of which, Sarsen, he's going to use his Dragon Blade, does pick up one onto one Jay Lee. That is only going to be one of them. We are going to be in overtime where all of these kills are going to be so much more important for trying to get this completion for the NC Foxes. Neko takes down Wicked again. This is a disaster. He just popped the Dragon Blade and was immediately punished. And now the NC Foxes looking to try and roll over the top of LW Red.
Okay, she did get a few more picks here, but 6v2 looks like it's going to happen. It took a long time, but they finally...
See, yeah, you mentioned lack of Primal Rage, but he has been able to get those barriers in the right positions.
Okay, if the Transcendence wears off, they can use the Dragon Blade. This is an opportunity here. Pumple's already down, but Sashin, maybe he can, if he wants to commit this, do a lot. He does pop it down. Now the Transcendence is up. Gets a health pack. He wants this.
Yeah, trying to get into this position as well. Sassen is able to take down 1J Lee, but it's not enough. Spent too much time away from his team, and no one had any resources. It's basically a wipe. This is the question. If they can actually make it here and stop this one...
Okay, Sashin gets the opening pick. This is a huge opportunity
for
them.
And they managed to jump onto the payload and stop that 3 meters out. So, so important, because this position is brilliant. If you are the defensive team, Hopper is going to be able to take down at least the mech, but 1J Lee, he's going to fall. You mentioned Sarsen, he was popping off to begin this one and is going to continue doing so as Hopper does get eliminated. The pilot D.Va unable to do anything.
That's it.
As the overtime is going to tick down, and that is that. NC Foxes are going to take it. That's the 3-2 victory. They turn around what happened last time. It's now them with the 3-game advantage. They're going to be facing Kongdoo Panthera in the winner's semi. And then Combox now has to deal with an angry LW Red.
The coach here, I think, has made all the right choices in terms of map selection, defensive setup.
처음엔 쟁탈전 했을 때 1라운드 졌어도 우리가 이길 것 같았는데 아쉽게 C9이 나와서 실수가 있었는데 멘탈 잡고 해가지고 너무 오래 걸렸던 것 같아요. 원래는 빨리 끝날 수 있는 경기였어요. 맵마다 좀 다른 것 같아요, 그거는. 정크렛이 좋은 맵도 있는데 안 좋은 맵도 있어요. 정크렛이 일단은 맵 구조상 좋은 데도 있는데 안 좋은 데도 있어서 그렇게 사기라고 할 수 있는 건 아니에요. 일단 오늘이긴 LW 레드도 위키드 선수가 파라를 잘하는데 자주 사용하지 않으셨어요. 있으면 LW 블루? 나노하나 선수? 잘하는 거. 콩드 판테라 같은 경우 딜러가 엄청 세잖아요. LW도 딜러가 셌는데 LW 레드도 지금 딜러가 셌는데 우리가 준비만 한다면 3대0으로 이길 수 있을 것 같아요. 저는 이펙트 선수 방송을 봤는데 펄스를 마우스 우클릭 버튼으로 쓰시더라고요. 그래서 그거 보고 저거 쓰면은 엄청 빨리 붙일 수 있을 것 같은데 그래서 우클릭 사용하고 있고 근접 공격 같은 경우는 다른 선수들도 쓰겠지만 F로 설정하고 다녀요. 일단 자판기 배열을 보면은 F는 움직이는 방향키에서 F가 더 가깝잖아요. 근데 V키 같은 경우는 아래쪽까지 내려야 돼서 오래 걸리는 거예요. 빨리 때리려고 F 설정합니다. 사람마다 다를 수도 있어요. 저희 스크림 할 때도 멘탈 관리해주시고 저희 스크림 질 때 왜 지는지 가르쳐주시는 훌륭한 코치님인 것 같아요. 그리고 상대를 분석해서 우리한테 전달해줘서 우리가 이렇게 이렇게 플레이하자라는 것까지 해주셔요.